6:14 in the Green Journey book, How Great Thou Art, number 614.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Robert died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Thank you.
you were pleased to create him in your own image and adopt him as your own, so command, we pray, that he may now share in your inheritance through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to be hated, a time of war and a time of peace. What profit have workers from their toil? I have seen the business of God that has given to mortals to be bruised about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts so they cannot find out. From beginning to end, the work which God has done, I recognize that there is nothing better than to rejoice and to do well during life. The word of the Lord.
There is nothing I shall. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to the Lord Jesus.
You may be seated. It didn't dawn on me until just now that I may have chosen the shortest gospel that I could find, so I apologize for that. I know you all like to hear me talk. But when I was reviewing the different gospels in our rites for funeral, this one just jumped out at me. You know, I talked about last night at the vigil service when I was praying about, you know, Bob is one of the first people that I can remember in my life. I remember my dad taking me and sitting me down in Bob's chair. You know, it was in his chair that I learned what I believe is my first dirty joke. Mind you, it didn't come from Bob himself. But I did learn some of the best life lessons from that chair. He really did. You know, how to treat people, how to spark up a conversation with just anybody. You know, as scared as I was to be there and have that, what I thought was a sheep shear coming straight at me, Bob was talking to me, talking me through it. This is what it is. This is what's going on. You know, now that I kind of look back, he was kind of like a counselor, wasn't he? You know, he was able to be with people on some of their best days and on some of their worst days. He helped people get ready for their baptisms, confirmations, weddings, and he also helped prep people for their place of rest. He did carry a burden, right? He did carry that burden to provide the best service that he could from the time that he started working, not only on the farm, but in the military, but as he began his barbering career. Not only willing to travel, or not only willing to set up shop here, and like we would expect here now today, we'd say, come to me, I'll serve you today here. But he was willing to travel those who needed his service, right? What a beautiful man. What a beautiful man. As I reflect on funerals and fully acknowledge that this group, this family that is here today is still grieving from a loss too soon. We acknowledge that. But it also brings me joy to know that we are here celebrating a life and remembering the lives that have gone before us. And it reassures me that this life is not the end. It truly isn't the end. We know that, right? This is just a pause, this life we're in. This is where we have our struggles. We have life everlasting with Christ. My brothers and sisters, we glance up here at the crucifix. You know, I said it at a wedding on Saturday, right? We glance up here at the crucifix, and what do we see? What do we see here? We see a man, but not just a man. We see God who came down to earth so that he could experience everything that we experience. Love, joy, pain, hatred. He experienced all that. He hated hate. He hated pain. He's a man that said, "Let this cup pass from me, but your will be done." He loved us and was willing to pay the price so that we could spend eternity with him. And we see him hanging on this cross right here, arms outstretched, saying, "My children, come to me." Right? "Come to me. I'm ready to embrace you." So as we reflect on our lives, the lives that have gone before us, imagine what it's like when we walk, when they walk into paradise. Can you imagine seeing the face of Christ, the true face of God, saying, "Come to me, my child, for you have worked hard, you have suffered, you have had pain. Give me all of that, because I gave it for you." My friends, family, on behalf of the Divine Mercy Parish, Father John Thomas, Father Matthew, our parochial vicar, and our pastor, Father McLeod, I want to assure you again of our continued thoughts and prayers, especially during this Advent season, when we continue to look forward of the coming of God, when he will stand in front of our tomb, in front of our graves, and say to us, like he said to his friend Lazarus, "Come out, come out, come with me." He will call us by name. Amen.
God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Let us pray for Robert, who in baptism died with Christ. May he now share in the fullness of his resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God is full of mercy and compassion. May he forgive Bob of any sin he committed through human frailty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends who have gathered here to mourn the passing of our friend, brother, and family member, Robert, that you may find strength and consolation in your Christian faith and in the love and support of this community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all consolation, help us to comfort one another in our grief, finding light in time. We pray for those of our loved ones who have gone before us. Lord, give them the reward of your goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who care for the sick and dying, especially those who cared for our brother Bob during his final days. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, You listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Mercifully receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering we trustingly present for the soul of your servant Bob, that through this sacrifice, which you ordained as the one true remedy for all, you may grant him everlasting salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Yes.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Walker, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Bob, whom today you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion song will be number 680, Amazing Grace, number 680.
Let us pray. Renewed by the nourishment of the sacred gift, we pray, O Lord, that our brother Bob, freed from the bonds of death, may rejoice to have a share in the resurrection of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
I know we are all feeling a little bit sad that we have lost our grandpa, our friend, and our dad. Together we have cried an ocean of tears as we feel so empty and hold many fears. But grandpa would want us to know that he's in a good place and that he's watching all of us with a smile on his face. As we have made him so proud as can be, that he raised such a beautiful and special family. Thinking back now, we really must say, we feel lucky and privileged to have known Grandpa to this day. For in our lives, he has played a special part, the memories we will treasure and keep close to our heart. For us, we are glad our little babies he got to meet, and for all of us, be grateful his life is now complete. To each one of us, he has loved and cared. As a family, be thankful for the good times we have shared. Although he is gone, we will always be together, and his spirit will live on in each of us forever. When you look to the sky, look for the brightest star, as that will be Grandpa looking down on us from afar. And now we would like to thank the good Lord above for blessing us with Grandpa with his kindness and love. Dear God, if it's not too much fuss, take extra special care of Grandpa, for he is dear to us. Grandpa, if you are listening, say a prayer for us every day. Be sure to protect us and guide us on our way. We know when God called you, you had to go. But we want you to know, Grandpa, we miss you and love you so.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Bob. May our farewell express our affection for him, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
The song of farewell will be number 550, O Loving God, number 550.
Thank you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Bob in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, you will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Bob in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Immediately following Mass, lunch will be served in the parish hall, which is through the doors to the left as you leave the church. And may the angels lead you into paradise, and may the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
The closing song will be number 671 on Eagle's Wings, number 671.